With the Soviet Union being the first to send an artificial satellite into space, and the first to send a human into space, they were clearly leading the space race. This caused the US president at the time, John F. Kennedy, to announce that they were going to safely send a human to the moon before the end of the 60s, in a bid to catch up and overtake the Soviet Union in the space race. From 1969 through to 1972, the United States sent and successfully landed 6 Apollo lunar landers on the moon, but the Soviet Union, who for the most part were ahead of the game, never saw a manned moon landing and are recognized as unsuccessful programs. With the N1-L3 rocket having 4 total launches and 4 failures, the Soviet Union never had much success and saw their attempts get cancelled. There are several contributing factors as to why the Soviet Union never made it to the moon. Firstly, the N1-L3 was underfunded and rushed, with the development of the rocket starting almost 4 years after America's Saturn V rocket. NASA spent about $23 billion on their efforts, whereas the Soviets spent anywhere from $4.8 billion to $10.1 billion, or essentially less than half of what NASA's budget for their manned missions were. Another major reason for the failures in the Soviets' efforts was the death of the chief designer and mastermind behind their efforts, and the Soviets were unable to find someone to replace him who had the same level of drive and leadership which he had. There was an inherent problem with the N1 launcher though, and that had to do with the number of engines the N1 launcher had compared to Saturn V. The N1 had an insane number of engines, with 30 little engines on the first stage compared to 5 enormous engines on the US Saturn V rocket. In total, the N1 rocket had 4 stages, with 30 engines in the first, 8 in the second, 4 in the third, and 1 in the fourth stage, whereas the Saturn V rocket had 3 stages, containing 5 engines in the first stage, 5 in the second stage, and 1 in the third stage. This involved a great amount of complexity for the Soviets in controlling 30 rocket engines in unison, which helped contribute to one of the main reasons all 4 launches failed. The US had the infrastructure to build the massive F1 engines they used for their Saturn V rockets, but the Soviets were not equipped with the infrastructure to match this and were forced to go down the route of creating smaller engines. The Soviets had a lot of firsts when it came to space, and if you were to have put money on it at the time, the Soviets seemed more likely to put a man on the moon first. But the US ended up coming on top, and as the feat of putting a man on the moon had already been achieved, for the Soviets, there wasn't really much more point to it anymore. In more recent times, Russia and US relations when it comes to space are much less of a competition or race, and more of a collaborative approach. With both Russian and American flight engineers both currently on the International Space Station, and the Russian Soyuz spacecraft being the only way for astronauts to get to and from the station, space for the time being has become a little bit less of a race and more of a cooperation between the two major countries. Thanks for watching and be sure to subscribe.